James Madison Jr. was an American statesman and founding father who served as the fourth president of the United States from 1809 to 1817. He's hailed as the father of the Constitution for his pivotal role in drafting and promoting the United States Constitution and the Bill of Rights. He served as both a member of the Virginia House of Delegates and as a member of the Continental Congress prior to the Constitutional Convention. After the convention, he became one of the leaders in the movement to ratify the Constitution, both in Virginia and nationally. His collaboration with Alexander Hamilton and John Jay produced the Federalist Papers, among the most important treatises in support of the Constitution. Madison's political views changed throughout his life. During deliberations on the Constitution, he favored a strong national government, but later preferred strong state governments, before settling between the two extremes later in his life. In 1789, Madison became a leader in the new House of Representatives, drafting many general laws. He's noted for drafting the first 10 amendments of the Constitution and thus is known also as the father of the Bill of Rights. He worked closely with President George Washington to organize the new federal government. Breaking with Hamilton and the Federalist Party in 1791, he and Thomas Jefferson organized the Democratic Republican Party. In response to the Alien and Sedition Acts, Jefferson and Madison drafted the Kentucky and Virginia resolutions, arguing that states can nullify unconstitutional laws. As Jefferson's Secretary of State, Madison supervised the Louisiana Purchase, which doubled the nation's size. Madison succeeded Jefferson as president in 1809, was re-elected in 1812, and presided over renewed prosperity for several years. After the failure of diplomatic protests and a trade embargo against the United Kingdom, he led the US into the War of 1812. The war was an administrative morass, as the United States had neither a strong army nor financial system. Madison has been ranked in the aggregate by historians as the ninth most successful president. In 1769, he enrolled at the College of New Jersey, now Princeton University. Madison graduated in 1771. His studies included Latin, Greek, science, geography, mathematics, rhetoric, and philosophy. Madison was married for the first time at the age of 43. On September 15, 1794, James Madison married Dolly Payne Todd, 26-year-old widow. Madison had no children but adopted Todd's one surviving son, John Payne Todd, after the marriage. Also, in 1794, Madison was elected a Fellow of the American Academy of Arts and Sciences. When her husband was president, Dolly Madison created the role of First Lady using her social talents to advance his program. She is credited with adding to his popularity in office. Madison's father died in 1801. At age 50, Madison inherited the large plantation of Montpelier and other holdings and his father's 108 slaves. With Jefferson's retirement imminent as his second term came to a close, Madison became his party's choice for president in 1808. The Republican Party Congressional Caucus chose the candidate and easily selected Madison over James Monroe. As the Federalist Party by this time had largely collapsed outside New England, Madison easily defeated Federalist Charles Cotesworth Pinckney. At a height of only 5 feet 4 inches and never weighing more than 100 pounds, he became the most diminutive president. Upon his inauguration in 1809, Madison immediately faced opposition to his planned nomination of Secretary of the Treasury, Albert Gallatin, as Secretary of State, led by William B. Giles. Madison chose not to fight Congress for the nomination but kept Gallatin, a carryover from the Jefferson administration, in the Treasury Department. Madison appointed Robert Smith for Secretary of State, Jefferson's former Secretary of the Navy. For his Secretary of the Navy, Madison appointed Paul Hamilton. Madison remains the only president to lead troops in battle while in office, although the battle did not go well for the American side. The British then raided Washington as Madison headed a dispirited militia. Dolly Madison rescued White House valuables and documents shortly before the British burned the White House, the Capitol, and other public buildings. Madison's final years began in an unprecedented period of peace and prosperity, which was called the Era of Good Feelings. Madison's reputation as president improved and Americans finally believed the United States had established itself as a world power. Like Jefferson, Madison had a paternalistic attitude toward American Indians, encouraging the men to give up hunting and become farmers. When Madison left office in 1817 at age 65, he retired to Montpelier, his tobacco plantation in Orange County, Virginia, not far from Jefferson's Monticello. In 1826, after the death of Jefferson, Madison was appointed as the second rector of the University of Virginia. He retained the position as college chancellor for 10 years until his death in 1836. In 1829, at the age of 78, Madison was chosen as a representative to the Virginia Constitutional Convention for revision of the Commonwealth's Constitution. It was his last appearance as statesman. Madison was also concerned about the continuation of slavery in Virginia and the South. He believed the transportation of free American blacks to Africa offered a solution as promoted by the American Colonization Society. Between 1834 and 1835, he sold 25% of his slaves to offset financial losses on his plantation. Madison died of heart failure at Montpelier on June 28, 1836. He was buried in the Madison family cemetery at Montpelier, which is maintained this day. Montpelier, his family's plantation and his home in Orange, Virginia, has been designated a National Historic Landmark. The James Madison Memorial Building is a building of the United States Library of Congress in Washington, D.C., and serves as the official memorial to Madison.